This first video is a quick walkthrough of a fictitious bottling plant project on a 3-inch Seymour Micro HMI graphic panel. You may be surprised at just how capable this little HMI panel is. Subsequent videos break down each individual screen so you can see how it all comes together and see some of the tricks you can use to get the most out of your Seymour Micro project. On this first screen, we can run, jog, or stop the process. There's a status message right here associated with that. Note that once we start the project, we can't unstart it. You have to press the button to stop the project. Down here, we have a process speed control, and by clicking on these arrows, we can change the speed of the process. And below that, there are function keys, which are used to switch between the different screens in the project. Let's go to the fan control screen. Here, we can turn the fans on and off using these rocker switches, or using the function keys. We can also go to the light screen here, where we can flip on the lights. We see little indicators come on with the switch to show us the status of the switch. And from there, we can go back to the fan screen, or we can go to the home screen. The home screen can also be reached via F1. The fan screens can be reached via F2. Let's hit the little house here to go home. The F3 button takes us to a status screen. This simply monitors the tags on the PLC and reports the results. These graphs are monitoring these tags down on the PLC. As the PLC modifies these tags, I'll change one or two here, we can see the results on the graphs. The only thing you can actually do on this screen is go home, unless you know the secret. The F5 key is set up to go to a screen that allows you to test the graphs. Here we can manually increment any of the graphs that we want to by changing these increment-decrement buttons. I'm actually modifying the tags down here on the PLC. And then when we go back to that screen, we can see the results here. Let's go home, click on the conveyor icon. On the conveyor screen, we can turn the various conveyors on either by clicking on the switches or by using the function keys, and we can go home. This button takes us to the recipe screen. Here we can select one of four lanes, the size of the bottle we want on that lane, and even adjust the mixture. So for the orange cola, you can see here's the current mix we have set up, but this is also set up where you can tweak the mix if you want to. We can change it from 286, how about to 360. Now our mix has changed. To get out of this screen, we can either go home or back to the bottle screen. That's it for the first set of screens. Now we hit the shift button and we have a whole other set of screens to explore. The first icon takes us to a screen menu where we can jump to any screen in the entire project. So using the function keys, I can scroll down or up through the entire project and go directly to that screen by hitting enter. The second shifted icon takes us to a setpoint screen. This screen demonstrates two different ways to enter numbers. We can select either of these boxes using F3 or F5 or just touching the box. This box uses the numeric entry dialog, so we can enter whatever number we want. This box uses the shift keys to enter the number. We can shift the cursor to the different digits and then use the function keys to change those digits. Again, on this screen, the home button takes us home, or the F1 will do the same thing. Back on our shifted screen here, the third icon takes us to a tracking screen where we can monitor the speed of a process and enable or disenable the auto tracking. Notice that the icons here change and the text above the tracking graph change. From the screen, we can also jump immediately to the fan control or to the adjustment screen where we can set the set points. And finally, we have our alarm screen where we can actually monitor the status of the alarms, or if we want to, we can manually trigger the alarm just to see what happens. Notice that we have a flashing backlight screen, we have a flashing LED, we have audio tones going off, and we have a blinking banner message across the top of the screen. There are also a few screens in this project just showing things like various bitmaps we could use, maximum text usage, and things like that. Now that we've seen the whole project, The following videos will break down each individual screen and show you how they were put together. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.